unofficial meeting of representatives of the main political parties in Parliament was chaired by Speaker Karujaya Surya at the Parliamentary Complex today. Ministers Nima Siripala de Silva, Dr. Vijayadasa Rajapaksha, Mahinda Samarasinghe, Douglas Devananda, and parliamentarians Dinesh Gunawardena, Ajit P. Pereira, Vijaypal Hettiarachchi, and Mano Ganeshan joined the meeting.
We requested the Speaker's intervention in the matter by way of letter, which included signatures of 125 parliamentarians. The Speaker has decided to convene the Parliament and promised us that he would convey the decision to the President in person. This was an informal meeting to hand over a letter to the Speaker requesting the Parliament be convened. We are yet to decide on our vote in Parliament. We will explore whether these issues arose due to anti-democratic conduct and make a decision.
In the meantime, the Speaker made a request from the President to convene the Parliament immediately, respecting democracy without letting a crisis manifest within the country. The letter the Speaker sent to the President reads that more than 125 parliamentarians have requested him in writing to establish the majority in Parliament to protect their parliamentary privileges and rights. Meanwhile, the European Union states the restless situation arisen in Sri Lanka is driving the country towards political instability and danger. Issuing a communique, the European Union points out that the President should take measures to convene the Parliament as soon as possible. In the meantime, Chinese Foreign Ministry's spokesperson Liu Kang states that China does not get involved in internal politics of Sri Lanka. He further states that China hopes Sri Lanka's political parties would resolve the issues by means of discussions. British and Canadian governments too request Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena to convene the Parliament immediately. Issuing communiques, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of those countries state that representatives in the Parliament, appointed by the vote of people democratically, must be given an opportunity to express their ideas. A fundamental rights petition was filed at the Supreme Court today, requesting the nullification of the gazette which prorogued the Parliament, stating it to be illegal. The petition was filed by Attorney at Law Nagananda Kurituwaku, and the respondents are former Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe, Speaker Karujaya Surya, and the Attorney General. In the meantime, the Secretary to the Prime Minister expressed views on the situation of temple trees.
Temple trees is the official residence of the Prime Minister. Usually, state officials can remain in the residences following the consent of the successor for several days. But ministers are not given such provisions. Staying at the residence or using the vehicle doesn't carry the ownership of the post. If someone uses property without the consent of the successor, that can be considered as misuse of state property. We have to realize the gravity of it. If needed, action can be taken under the Public Property Act.